Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 16th mission of the year with the launch of HTS-113BT.
One, ignition, and liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1067, then landed successfully for the 17th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
And there you have it.
Confirmed.
That landing marks SpaceX's 275th recovery of an orbital class rocket.
SpaceX posted some information after this launch. They said Falcon 9 completes its 300th successful mission. We can hopefully expect to see another couple of launches this week. The Starlink 715 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 23rd at 4.02 a.m. UTC or Thursday 22nd at 11.02 p.m. EST. Then, the following day, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission. The Starlink 639 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 24th at 9.59pm UTC or 4.59pm EST. There was an article posted related to another payload SpaceX will be launching later this year. It says the first spy satellite in India to be made by a local private player is set to be launched in a SpaceX rocket by April and will be used by the armed forces to get discrete information, the Economic Times reported on Monday. SpaceX posted some pictures of the next Crew Dragon capsule that will fly. They said Dragon arrives at the hangar at Pad 39A in Florida ahead of its fifth flight to the space station. Falcon 9 is targeted to launch Dragon and Crew 8 to the orbiting laboratory no earlier than Friday, March 1st. Heading to Boca Chica, work has been seen continuing around the launch site. A whole bunch of Launch Tower 2 sections were seen delivered to Starbase from KSC. There was some exciting information posted with Musk saying when SpaceX is aiming for the flight-free launch. It says Elon Musk said SpaceX is aiming for the second week of March for the third flight of Starship. The probability of reaching orbit is almost 80%. Flight 4 hardware is almost ready. There was further exciting information posted related to activity for Flight 3. This post says a shipment of Starship FTS explosives has arrived at the launch complex this morning. Always a good sign that a launch is approaching. Ship 28 was recently destacked from Booster 10 off to the wet dress rehearsal aborts. Ship 28 was then seen moved over to the Pad B test mount. Starship 28 was also seen lifted onto the Pad B test mount. Additionally to Ship 28, Booster 10 was also lifted and removed from the launch mount. Booster 10 was also rolled back to the production site for some extra work to be done. It was rolled into the mega bay and lifted onto the work stand. To finish up the video today, we'll take a quick look at the Cameron County website where the closure on Tuesday was revoked. They have possible closures still for this week though, with tomorrow, Thursday 22nd and Friday 23rd. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.